Hello all, this is the video about three effective tools for e-learning. Here is a list of three essential tools for e-learning. First is we need a virtual classroom. That is, we create a classroom environment through electronic devices, internet and other platforms. Here we are going to discuss about Google Classroom as a virtual classroom. There are other platforms like Moodle, Blackboard and all where large amount of money is needed, which will not be suitable for us. Google Classroom, with certain restrictions, they are giving it for free. Then the second tool is going to be the survey tools. The most commonly used survey tool for learning purpose will be the Google Forms. The third one is the meeting app through which we interact with the students face to face. Here we will be discussing about the Zoom app, which is most commonly used meeting app. So what can we do with Google Classroom? Through Google Classroom, both teacher and student can communicate, collaborate, they can create and manage classes. They can, teachers can give assignments, students can do it, submit it, grade it. This grading can be done manually or automatically. And if the Google Classroom account is linked with G Suite accounts, then parents can get the notification of their assignments and the reminders for the assignments, etc. So now let me show you how Google Classroom appears and how it works. All these applications, all these three applications, both Google Classroom, Google Forms, Zoom app, these three combo is available both in desktop and that is available for PC and mobile also. Mobile apps are also available.
So let me show how Google Classroom works. So, functioning of Google Classroom, you need a Gmail account. So, through which you can see the tiles here. Click these tiles, and down you can see this Google Classroom icon. Click on it, then it will open. So, when you open it, it will appear, the screen will appear like this. So this plus sign indicates create or join a class. If you are a teacher, you just create this class. If you are a teacher, a student, then you have to join this, click on join this class. And through this class code, if you enter a class code of that particular class, you can join the class. So through which I'm opening the window which we are having as a classroom. So here we are the teachers. And here are the students. So this is the list of students through which what we can do is we can select one student and we can mail that person personally, email that person personally, or we can click on this and select all the students and we can send email reminders to the students. So this is the main page or the classwork page. Here if we go to this create, we can create assignments, quiz, we can ask a question, we can share a material, we can reuse a post which is already used in some other class. Then we can create a topic discussion and this quiz assignments can be done. For this quiz assignment, we need Google Forms. That is our second tool, that is a survey tool, Google Form, that is coming up. So now this is the stream thing. This is our class code. So if we click on this, it will be displayed in the classroom, in your real classroom. So if the student enter this, then they can join this class. So now this is the example what and all we have shared in with this with our class. So in classwork, we can open this. This was the assignment which we gave, and the best thing about Google Classroom is that when we create an assignment, we title it as homework, and we can just assign it, or any for that matter assignment or announcement, we can directly assign immediately, or we can schedule it in a particular time. Suppose if we want to conduct the test on a particular time or make announcement at particular time, we can schedule it. This is the best part with the Google Classroom. So let me show how Google Forms works. So if you click on Forms in Google, it will automatically give these forms. So through these forms, you can go to this form, Google Forms, click on this Google Forms. Now we have template gallery where we can use already existing templates, or if you want a new form. Now Google Forms opens like this. So we have a question like this, so we can have this kind of questions asked here. So this is the usual Google Forms, you will be familiar. So if we go to settings, and if we make it as a quiz, then it can be used easily in the classroom. So here we can see whether we can decide whether we can release the grade immediately or later after the manual review. So these two options are possible. Then here in presentation, we can this is about Google Forms, we can select any one of these options, and we may or may not collect email address. We can limit to only one response if it is an exam, and we can use this option edit. We can give some time to for them to read and edit their answer till the quiz is open. So that is about Google Forms. So here is how to use Zoom application. So when we type Zoom meetings will appear. So just click on this. If you want to join the meeting, you can directly join without signing in. If you want to host a meeting, then you need to sign in. So there, after signing in, you want to host a meeting means, if you click on that host the meeting, then there will be a code. Then if you send that code to the people can join easily. So here I have some videos to show how our presentations. So through these presentations, we can share our screen. Students can scribble. We also can scribble.
This United Nations International Emergency Fund. It is not education fund, but it is now called as United Nations Children's Fund. That's all.
So this is one video presentation where we share our slides, have the class. And this is one more presentation.
Principles of primary health care, they have asked identity deficiency disorder and control program. Now I'm talking about all the three chapters which we are going to deal today. Nutrition.
So it will the screen will appear like this for the students. So you can share your screen, you can share your presentations. The teacher can teacher will be teacher's face will be like this. Students, if they want to show their face, they can show. If they don't want, they need not show. If they want to ask, scribble the board, they can use. They can play with it. So you also can try these apps in your settings.
Hope this presentation was useful for you. All the best for implementing these tools in your work setting.